Welcome to all graduate and undergraduate students of Biosciences in Radio Khanchi 90.4 FM, Hum Sabka Radio. I am Dr. Rupa Verma from Department of Botany, Ranchi University, Ranchi. Today I will discuss on biochemistry subject. This is an evolving science. Biochemistry is the study of the chemistry of life processes. Biochemistry aims to explain biological forms and functions in chemical terms. Biomolecules are compounds of carbon with a variety of functional groups. Macromolecules are the major constituents of cells, such as protein, nucleic acid, and polysaccharides. These are macromolecules composed of monomers with molecular weight of 500 or less. So, carbohydrates are the most abundant biomolecules on Earth. Each year, photosynthesis converts more than 100 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide in water into cellulose and other plant products. Oxidation of carbohydrate is the central energy yielding pathway in most non-photosynthetic cells. In this lecture, I will explain the major classes of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketones or substances that yield such compounds on hydrolysis. Carbohydrates mainly contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen in 1:2:1 ratio. Apart from the main source of energy for all living organism, carbohydrates also is the main structural component. Example, DNA contain carbohydrate ribose, plant cell wall contain cellulose. The word saccharide comes from the Greek word for sugar. So there are four major classes of carbohydrate: monosaccharide, disaccharide, oligosaccharide and polysaccharide. First one is monosaccharide. These are simple sugars consist of single polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone. The most abundant monosaccharides in nature is the 6-carbon D-glucose, which is also known as dextrose. Monosaccharides of 4 or more carbon tend to have cyclic structures. The two families of monosaccharides are aldoses and ketoses. If the carbonyl group is at the end of the carbon chain, the monosaccharide is an aldose. And if carbonyl group is at any other position, the monosaccharide is a ketose. The simplest monosaccharides are the 2-3-carbon trioses, that is glyceraldehyde, that is an aldotrioses, and dihydroxyacetone, which is ketotriose. Monosaccharides with 4, 5, 6 and 7 carbon atoms in their backbones are called respectively tetroses, pentoses, hexoses and heptoses. All the monosaccharides except dihydroxyacetone contain one or more asymmetric carbon atoms and occur in optically active isomeric forms. As for example, a simplest sugar, glyceraldehyde, which contains one chiral center and have two different optically isomers or enantiomers. In general, molecules have n chiral centers can have 2 to the power n stereoisomers. So, glyceraldehyde can have 2 stereoisomers. The molecules which have 4 chiral centers have 16 stereoisomers. Disaccharide consists of 2 monosaccharides joined by a glycosidic bond. They are crystalline, water-soluble and sweet to taste. The disaccharides are of 2 types, reducing disaccharides and non-reducing disaccharides. Reducing disaccharides contain free aldehyde or ketone group, as for example maltose and lactose. Non-reducing sugars with no free aldehyde or ketone groups are sucrose and trihalose. The common disaccharides are maltose, lactose and sucrose. In maltose, 2 alpha glucose units joined together by alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond. The monosaccharide alpha glucose is so called alpha glucose because they are in alpha configuration. Alpha carbohydrates, the OH group of C1 is opposite to the direction of CH2OH. That's why it is called alpha glucose. In lactose, one beta galactose unit joined to another beta glucose unit to form lactose. Beta 1,4 glycosidic bond involved here. This bond contain beta linkage, and the process or the reactions involved here is condensation reactions for formation of beta 1,4 glycosidic bond. In sucrose, one alpha glucose unit joined by another beta fructose unit to form sucrose. Sucrose is also called as table sugar and formed by plants and not animals. Here glucose alpha 1,2 beta fructose glycosidic bond forms. Let's look at oligosaccharides, which is less than 20 monosaccharides units. Here 20 monosaccharides links together by alpha 1,4 bonds. A number of trisaccharides occur free in nature, which is found in abundance in sugar beets and many hybrid plants. Example, raffinose. The other carbohydrate is polysaccharides, which contain many monosaccharides units joined in long linear or branch chains. Polysaccharides have two major biological functions: as a storage form or structural elements. Most of the carbohydrates found in nature occur as polysaccharides of higher molecular weight. On complete hydrolysis with acid or specific enzyme, these polysaccharides yield monosaccharides or simple monosaccharides derivatives. There are two types of polysaccharides. First one is homopolysaccharides and second is heteropolysaccharides. Homopolysaccharides contain same type of monomeric unit. In other words, homopolysaccharides which on hydrolysis yield only a single type of monosaccharides. Examples are starch, cellulose, glycogen, dextrins, inulin, chitin are homopolymers. Heteropolymers contains different types of monomeric units and they are on hydrolysis yield different type of monosaccharides. Example, hyaluronic acid consists of alternative residues of D-glucuronic acid and N-acetyl D-glucosamine and is thus a heteropolysaccharides. Some important homopolysaccharides are starch. Starch is the chief form of fuel storage in plants. Starch occurs in two forms, alpha amylose and amylopectin. Alpha amylose consisting long unbranched chains in which all the D-glucose units are bound in alpha 1,4 linkages. Amylose can be hydrolyzed by alpha amylase, which is present in saliva and pancreatic juice and participate in the digestion of starch in the gastrointestinal tract. Amylopectin is highly branched. The average length of the branched is from 24 to 30 glucose residues. Here we have regular alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond and branching point of alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond. Second example is glycogen. The most common homopolymer in animal cells is glycogen, the storage form of glucose. Glycogen is specially abundant in the liver. It is also present about 1-2% in skeletal muscles. The most common of the glucose units in glycogen are linked by alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond. The branches are formed by alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond present about once in 10 units. Cellulose is the other major polysaccharides of glucose found in plants, serves a structural rather than a nutritional value. It is unbranched polymer of glucose residues joined by beta-1-4 linkages. Here, glucose molecules have beta configurations, so bonds are beta-1-4 glycosidic bond. Human doesn't have this enzyme to break this bond, so human cannot digest cellulose. Dextrins are other polysaccharides which are found in bacteria and yeast. Another one is chitin, which is composed of N-acetyl D-glucosamine unit held together by beta-1-4 glycosidic bond. It is found in exoskeleton of some invertebrates. Now come to the heteropolysaccharides. When polysaccharides are composed of different of sugars or their derivatives, they are referred as heteropolysaccharides or heteroglycans. Mucopolysaccharides are heteroglycans made up of repeating units of sugars derivatives, namely amino sugars and uronic acids. These are more commonly known as glycosaminoglycan or GAG. GAG is made up of repeating unit of disaccharides containing amino sugars, either glucosamine or galactosamine. GAGs are usually attached to proteins to form mucoprotein or mucoids or proteoglycans. Proteoglycans functions as lubricants and structural components in connective tissues, mediate added adhesions of cells to the extracellular matrix and bind factors that stimulate cell proliferations. The important mucopolysaccharides includes chondroitin sulfate, keratin sulfate, heparin. Chondroitin sulfate, these are consist of repeating units of disaccharides composed of D-glucuronic acid and N-acetyl D-galactosamine 4-sulfate. It is a major constituent of various mammalian tissues like bone cartilage, heart walls, skin, etc. Another one is keratin sulfate. It consists of alternating units of D-galactosamines and N-acetyl glucosamino 6-sulfate. Keratin sulfate keeps cornea transparent. Like that, heparin composed of alternating unit of N-sulfo-D-glucosamine 6-sulfate and glucuronate 2-sulfate. Heparin is anticoagulant that occurs in blood, lung, liver, kidney, spleen, etc. Like that, dermatan sulfate. The name dermatan sulfate derived from the fact that this compound mostly occurs in the skin. It is structurally related to chondroitin 4 sulfate. The only difference is that there is an inversion in the configuration around C5 of D glucuronic acid to form L-hydronic acid. Next one is hyaluronate. It is also known as hyaluronic acid. It is composed of alternate units of O-glucuronic acid and N-acetyl D-glucosamine. These two molecules are held together by beta-glycosidic bond. It promotes wound healing. So, today I have discussed all types of carbohydrate, that is monosaccharide, disaccharide, oligosaccharide and polysaccharides. This is audio lecture, so I can't explain the biomolecule structures here. For structural detail, go through the book Leninger and Strye. In the next lecture, I shall be discussing how this molecule is involved in energy yielding pathways. Thank you to all students and listeners.